Hi, my name's Suzanne and I'm a tech writer here at F5. Today I'm going to show you how to spin up a new instance of BIGIP VE or Virtual Edition in the Microsoft Azure portal. So to get started, you click on the Marketplace link and then you'll search for F5 Hourly. There's two main types of licenses, hourly, which is also referred to as utility or pay as you go, and then BYOL, which means bring your own license. It basically means you have a license key that you got from F5, whether it's a trial or a production license. But for ease of use today, I'm just going to grab one of these hourlies. And they come in good, better, or best. And you can do some research on this. There's documentation on our website. And then these are throughput limits. So I'm going to choose a better with a 1 gig throughput limit. The license is going to top me off there at 1 gig. Now I'm going to create my instance, just give it a name, choose storage. Remember your username for later because it can be harder to find and you want to make sure you know. That's basically the admin username. Now give it a strong password. Well, for production, obviously you're going to use a key, but for test purposes, give it a strong password. It has to have 3 out of 4 of those symbols and uppercase, lowercase, and it'll gripe at you if you don't do it right. And then I have an existing resource group that I created because I have an application server already out there. Sometimes this is a little tricky. There we go. And click OK. Now I'm going to have to choose an Azure instance type. There are recommended ones that'll be displayed here. Again, you should do a little bit of research, look at the prices, look at the number of cores, and or just pick one of the recommended ones like I did. Spend your company's money. I'm going to shut this off right after. Anyway, it's doing a last minute verification, and now I'm just going to click purchase. Now, once it starts deploying, I can click this, I believe, to see the status, but I like to go back to this bell here, and it'll show you, in fact, here's where you can see the admin username again. It'll show you the details of your deployment and all of the different things that it's going to be creating. And let me give it a refresh. So you can see here down at the bottom, it's already started to do things. First thing it did was create this network security group. So we're going to mess with that while it's still spinning everything up. As you can see, it's still deploying. It's going to be a little while before it gets the BIGIP virtual machine set up. So in the meantime, I want to mess with the security group. But to get there, I'm going to search for my security or my resource group. This is where I like to come to see all of the different resources. It's just sort of a nice starting point. That's just my personal preference. You can do whatever the heck you want. Here is my BIGIP network security group. I have another one for my application server, and I was getting these confused, so just be careful here. Here is, this basically says, you know, here's how you can connect. Right now it's saying, okay, when the BIGIP is created, I don't mean to keep clicking here. When the BIGIP is created, I can use PuTTY to connect to port 22 and access my BIGIP from the command line. But I also want to be able to access what's called the management config utility, and that's accessible by default on port 443. So I'm going to create a security rule that says, hey, now I can access BIGIP from port 443 as well. And then, as soon as this is done, there we go, I need to add one more. I'm actually going to move what we call the management port from 443 to 8443 because I want to use 443 for my web traffic. So I'll switch it and then I can come back and delete this 443 later. Or actually, I think I'm going to leave that. Anyway, I need a rule so I can connect to management and so traffic can go through my virtual server. That's right. Okay, I have my three rules. Now I'm going to go back here and I can see that the deployment is still spinning. So I'm going to just, it started creating the VM, but it's still kind of spinning up and getting itself ready. So I'm just going to pause the video for a second and I'll come back in just a few minutes when the BIGIP is up and running. Okay, we're back. Now you can see that the status changed to deployment succeeded, and if you click the little bell, you can see that everything worked itself out. So now I'm going to go back to my resource group, and I'm going to look at the BIGIP VE instance, and I'm going to see what its public IP address is, and I'm going to copy that. And now I'm going to connect to it. Now I did HTTPS because this is coming through port 443 to begin with. And I'm going to proceed. And I get the login page for the BIGIP configuration. Oops, force of habit. And I'm going to use the username and password that I specified when I was deploying it. And I'm just going to take a quick look here. Okay, now I'm just going to run through the setup utility. Just a couple of steps to get the BIGIP ready to go. On this page, you can provision different modules by enabling or disabling them. Click Next again. I'm going to give it a host name. And I have to re-enter my password. And then I'm finished. Okay, the next thing I want to do is I want to connect via SSH using PuTTY. And I'm going to change the config utility port, the port here from 443 to 8443, so that I can use 443 for my traffic, for my web traffic. Great, so I'm going to log in. Now, we've got some documentation on the exact steps, so I'm just going to run through these pretty quickly. But basically, I'm adding 8443, and I am getting rid of 443 as a port for management. So, and as you can see, it's already logged me off in the background there because it knows that that port is no longer allowed. Now I'm going to confirm the list. Okay, HTTPS is listed there. That's what I want. And now I'm going to save sysconfig to commit my changes. Great. Now I come back here. Now I have to give this the specific 8443 if I want to connect to it. There we go. So from now on, whenever I want to connect to the configuration utility, I need to append the 8443 at the end. Now I'm going to do two quick things to set up BIGIP to process traffic to my simple web page, my HTTPS web page. So the first thing I do is I create a pool. And I'm going to need the IP address of my application server, so I'm going to come back in my resource group. I see my application server. I'm actually going to look at the network interface associated with my application server and grab this private IP address. So there's my application server's IP address. And now I go in here and I'm going to create a pool that has this as a member. So I'm just going to call this Suzanne pool and give it HTTPS. Here's the address, and it's port 443. Add it to my list and click Finished. Now I've got a pool. Now the last thing I need to do is create a virtual server. So to do this, I want to get the private IP address of my BIGIP. And again, I'm going to copy that here. Now I'm going to create my virtual server that serves to the pool. So there is VS. Okay, now here's the address that it's going to go to. And I'm going to give it the HTTP profile, client SSL, server SSL, SNAT automap, and finally I'm going to give it my pool. Now the final test is going to be that I want to hit this address at port 443, and it should give you, fingers crossed, my fabulous web page. This web page is going to blow you away. I worked on it a long time, and there you go. So now basically when I'm connecting to the public IP address, it's sending traffic through the big IP to my application server, to my web page. That's a basic setup that you can run yourself and have yourself up and running and impress your colleagues in a short amount of time. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.